This is Mr. Fugu, and you are watching Mr. Fugu's Data Science. And tonight, we'll be doing a how-to for generating fake data using R within the Jupyter Notebook. The initial setup for this is a little tedious and somewhat frustrating if anyone has any problems or concerns with getting R to work within Jupyter Notebook. I could attach a PDF on my GitHub page, and that'll be in the link and description below the video, as well as within the GitHub page of mine, which is GitHub/MrFuguDataScience. Now, one complication that I had was installing packages. I thought initially I could just run these libraries and it would just open. And apparently I figured out that's just not the case. Some of these just don't connect. I don't know what the real deal is. So I had to install these separate. If you're in a position where you're doing this frequently, I would suggest writing a little function or a script that could just automate this for you to just save you a little time and make your code a little neater. Nevertheless, the initial library here is basically just for personal information, whereas this is for random names that we'll be utilizing here. You could basically read these descriptions later. This is going to be a short video. So what I wanted to do is create some fake user info where we're doing 6,000 credit cards, email addresses, birthdays, which are in the from the generator library. The random names is from the random names library, where we're calling first and last. We create a bunch of phone numbers as well. We want to create a list with everything. Convert that list into a data frame where the rows are the length of our list. This is the basic printout of all of our junk. Now, what we're doing is taking the data frame, taking a specific amount of rows with all columns. We have to also label all of our columns, which is used with these assignments here. And then before we proceed, I need to mention something. When you're dealing with pseudo-random data generation, you end up having issues with duplicates. And depending on the use, it may be an issue and you may have to exclude that data. In this case, I wanted to figure out what data am I having duplicates with. So I noticed that the last name and the first name were duplicates. So I said, how do I want to take care of this? Now, I found that there were 13 matches that were a combination of the first and last name together. Is what I had interest in. And so I figured, well, am I going to get rid of this or am I going to keep it? And that's going to depend. Am I using this in a relational database or a NoSQL database? And if it's relational, what exactly is my primary key? It definitely isn't going to be a name because you could have repeating names. Therefore, you should have some kind of identifying qualifier. In a NoSQL database like Postgres or Mongo, you have a lot more flexibility in terms of lack of schema. So what I found is out of these 13 names, combinations of names, do I want to keep these or not? I'm going to have to think about that for the next project where we're going to export these CSV files an interface from R directly to Postgres and MySQL. So, sorry about that. I had to create from the list of users, convert it back into a matrix, and then dump it as a CSV file where, let's find out if we have it. We don't have it yet. This is from the last video. So we're going to call this fake users R. Now this check. And there it is. It just sent us our little video. And here's a little preview for next time, since we're going to send files from R to MySQL. If I could get this to open, let's see what happens. Bam! Well, why don't you get happy, because we're going to have some fun next time. Now I'd like to say thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. And as always, if you have any questions or topics you want me to cover in the future, please let me know. And thank you for watching. Bye.